It's my pleasure to welcome you all here. My name is Mandeep Kaur. I am primary coordinator here. And today we are going to explore key strategies and tools to enhance literacy and numeracy skills in our students. And we know Government of India has launched a foundational literacy and numeracy mission, and has provided guidelines to build the desired literacy and numeracy skills in children at foundational stage. As we all know that early 8 years are very important, and it is the most significant period of growth and development of a child's life. So strong foundation in early years have a lasting impact on child's holistic development. So according to new education policy, what is the present structure? Yes. It is already here. It is 5 plus 3 plus 3 plus 4. This one is the previous structure when 10 years from 1st to 10th, and this was the lower one was the classes. Hana? Now, and 2 years of plus 1 and plus 2. Now, changed structure is first 5 years, that is foundational stage, that is from nursery to second. Then, second one is 3rd to 5th, it is preparatory stage. And in 3rd, from 6th to 8th, it is middle stage, 3 years of middle stage. And then 9th to 12th, 4 years of secondary stage. So it is divided into 4 sections now. And as sir told that we have to focus more and more for foundational literacy and numeracy in our students. We know we have 3 key elements of NEP 2020 to implement in all the schools throughout India. Uniform curriculum and pedagogy to be followed in all the schools. And today we are going to go through foundational literacy and numeracy in short. Foundational literacy and numeracy is a child's ability to read with meaning and to do basic math operations or calculations. So FLN mission is about building foundational literacy and numeracy skills among the children of 3 to 9 years age group. Then we know that strong literacy and numeracy skills help children to learn, experiment, reason and create, to be active learners and informed citizens, and to contribute socially, culturally and economically. So we have objectives of foundational literacy and numeracy. So for literacy, an FLN ready child will be able to listen and respond orally with meaning, identify all the letters and their sounds, read words by blending letters, sounds, read grade level text with meaning, write sentences to communicate meaning. And for numeracy, an FLN ready child will be able to identify 3-digit numbers, understand the place value, solve 3-digit addition, subtraction, 2-digit multiplication and division problems, and understand shapes and patterns around them, understand the concept of length, height, weight, and classify and interpret given data. And then we have key components. First of all, let's go through literacy. And here we have the key components of literacy. These are, as you can see, phonological awareness, phonics, fluency, vocabulary, and comprehension. So phonological awareness can be taught at each level, and it includes skills such as counting, categorizing, rhyming, blending, segmenting and manipulating, means adding, deleting or substituting words. Then we have phonics, and it is the science of sounds. It is to make the child understand the relationship between sounds and letters. Then we have fluency. It is reading smoothly and with expression. Then we have vocabulary. Building a robust vocabulary among the children so that they can use freely. Then we have comprehension. When the child has made and he has his own vocabulary, then he or she can be very confident to use the language. And he or she can be able to understand the given text and interpret the text. Now, as a teacher, So teaching strategies for literacy are phonic instructions. Means you all are giving them phonic instructions. So to teach the use of phonics, you use games and activities. So kindly please share any favorite activity of yours which you use.
Writing activities, I think the students can imagine their thing out of the word.
Yes.
And they can write their views.
Yes.
We will give some key words to them and they will frame sentences of their own.
That's great. And if we add the objects, means if we start from the concrete things, if we give them any object, for example, that will be more easy. And when you give them guided, you guide, write some points here. Ask them to speak up. For example, for small kids, if we give them any, tell them to bring their toy. Yes. 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 That's great. That's great. Yes. 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 Great. Yes. These are means if we use these things in daily life, then it will be easy to make them competent in their language. So storytelling is one of that. And children love the story, so we have to make them encourage them for reading stories and telling stories in their own words. And next we have interactive read aloud. Means when we read aloud and ask them to read along with us, we choose a text and ask them.
We can improve the fluency of the students.
Yes.
Or the
yes. And one more thing, if we give them group activities, they become more confident. Means if there are few children, मतलब कुछ ऐसे बच्चे हैं जो थोड़ा feel करते हैं, shy feel करते हैं, तो अगर हम उनको एक group में रख रहे हैं जहाँ पे काफी yes they learn from them. Means अगर मैं उनको ज़्यादा करवाऊँगी, focus करवाऊँगी, तो वो उतना नहीं कर पाते हैं जितना वो दूसरों से group में सीखते हैं. Yes, peer discussions. And then writing activities. So for writing activities, like I will show you one dice. Here we have written the letters. And anyone please come here and do this activity. For an example, give them. Call one, he or she will throw. And then the letter which comes. Yandu, you will tell the word on that letter, on the word.
Starting with that letter.
They will use.
Rose.
Very good. Then next one.
F-E. Or we have to choose from this dice only.
We have to give the children dice. This is heavy only five. Yes. Like a game. This is just like a game. We will pass. They will throw the which number is appeared on it. They will tell the word on it.
Yes.
Later on, we will tell them to make the sentences. First of all, words. Then they will make the sentences. Yes. And when they are, जब उनको बोलते हैं कि आपको पढ़ना है, तो फिर बड़ा बुरा लगता है. When we indulge them in an activity, yes.
So,
on the name of game, they are ready to study. So need to inculcate such practices. And for same way for writing, मतलब जैसे अभी उनको दे दिया हमने बोलने के लिए, same way for writing. We can give them words, ऐसे ही words की बना सकते हैं, या फिर object दे दिया तो उसके ऊपर writing के लिए बोलिए. So next we have key components of numeracy. And first one is number sense. to make the students understand the numbers and their relationships. So to teach them basic operations, addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, etc. To enable them for applying mathematical concepts to solve real world problems, and spatial awareness, understanding the shapes, sizes, patterns in their surroundings. And for these key components, we have these teaching strategies for numeracy. First of all, manipulatives. We can use different objects.
Like in maths, we will use dice balls.
Yes.
Counting strings we have.
Beads also. If nothing, then pebbles also.
Yes.
Marbles, pebbles. Even objects in the class. For example, we have five fans, na? So how many wings in one fan? That is three. So how many in two or how many in five? Like this. So maths games. I think all of us are using. So please share with others and even you also, which maths games we are using for make them competent in numeracy. This is good. We have to make them responsible for the things. जो भी चीज़ें आस पास में हैं उनको देखें समझें. मतलब number is not a numbers, मतलब just it must be instilled in them. तो मतलब उनको इतने कॉम्पिटेंट बनाना है कि नहीं, जैसे वो भूल जाते हैं या कुछ भी, they can teach. Even अगर कोई बच्चे काफ़ी अच्छे हैं तो we can give them topic. ओके, आज तुमने addition सिखानी है सबको, तो let's see, पहले देखो मैम कैसे सिखाते हैं. तो when they learn like this way, जब वो
हाँ
Yes. That is good. और जब भी हमने ये basic operations start करने हैं तो we will start with CPA approach. So first of all concrete objects, then pictures, then abstract, then numbers. I think we need to involve all. That is good जो आप बता रहे हैं. तो अगर सबको ज़्यादा involvement करनी है तो ask them to count the boys and girls and add them. जो भी चीज़ें आसपास में बढ़ी हैं उनको ऐड करो और फाइंड आउट करो. सो फॉर असेसमेंट ऑफ असेसमेंट टेक्निक्स, दीज ऑल वी आर यूजिंग फॉर्मेटिव असेसमेंट एंड इन फॉर्मेटिंग फॉर्मेटिव असेसमेंट मे बी क्विज और एंड रेगुलर क्विजेज, ओरल क्वेश्चंस, इंटरैक्टिव एक्टिविटीज. These all kinds are under formative assessment, and then we have summative assessment at the end of the term. Okay, then observations, when during the classroom activities we observe them, how they are learning, hana? If any child is lacking, then we can focus on that or call them, or means peer, if them give them work in peer or groups or pairs, it is very means very useful. So we have to make them independent. So we need to encourage more and more group activities in class, and we often got mainly we got these complaints, and mostly parents yahi bolte hain, ma'am aapki baat sunta hai, meri to sunta nahi hai, to aap isko bol do, hai na. So we face this thing. Or so these are few challenges which we already discussed. Diverse learning paces and styles, because we have the children from different we can say different learning pace also, hana? Different religions also, different backgrounds also, so different areas also, means some are from urban and then villages. So we need to see how we can inculcate these literacy and numeracy in among these children. So we need to plan according that. So differentiated instructions we need to plan. Next we have limited resources. In schools we have resources enough, but in few schools they don't have. So it is for all maybe. So for that we can utilize digital tools and resources, and we can aware the parents also for the same, because at home they don't have this much. Maybe I am not here to tell you something. मैं आपसे सीखने ही वाली हूँ, ऐसा नहीं है कुछ भी कि we are expert in something. We all are learning teaching.
Classroom is very important.
Yes. लैक ऑफ पेरेंटल इन्वॉल्वमेंट. यस, मैनी ऑफ देम डोंट इन्वॉल्व बट वी हैव टू मेक देम. तो इसके लिए ना व्हेन वी अटेंड दिस वर्कशॉप, हाँ व्हेन वी अटेंड दिस वर्कशॉप, तो मैम ने बताया एक वहाँ पे प्रिंसिपल थे, दी शी टोल्ड के हम पेरेंट्स को कैसे बुलाते हैं स्कूल में, उनको ये बोलते हैं क्योंकि आपके बच्चे ने प्रेजेंटेशन रेडी की है, जस्ट कम हेयर एंड सी द प्रेजेंटेशन. तो फिर तो वो आएंगे ही, तो बच्चे की प्रेजेंटेशन रेडी करवाइए, कुछ भी शो देम, और उसके बाद बैठो और उनसे पूरा एंड डिटेल में डिस्कस करो कि ओके यू हैव टू डू दिस 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 थिंग फॉर योर चाइल्ड, है ना. सो एंगेजिंग पेरेंट्स थ्रू रेगुलर कम्युनिकेशंस एंड इन्वॉल्वमेंट. सो वी हैव टू इन्वॉल्व देम एंड बिकॉज मे बी यू ऑल्सो फेसिंग दिस कि कुछ पेरेंट्स होते हैं वो आते ही नहीं है पीडीएम्स में, हमारे यहाँ तो हैं आई थिंक मे बी, है ना, मे बी नॉट इन कैम्ब्रिज बट वी आर फेसिंग एंड मे बी यू आर ऑल्सो फेसिंग कि पीटीएम पे नहीं आते हैं पेरेंट्स, तो उनको बुलाने के लिए फिर ये ठीक है कि आपके बच्चे ने ये चीज़ रेडी की है, वी विल शो देम, तो दे विल बी हैप्पी ऑल्सो एंड मे बी दे विल लिसन यू ऑल्सो, है ना. देन आवर रोल एज टीचर्स एंड पेरेंट्स, सो वी हैव टू क्रिएट अ सपोर्टिव लर्निंग एनवायरमेंट एंड फॉर पेरेंट्स दे हैव टू हाँ यस दे हैव टू सपोर्ट लर्निंग एट होम द सेम, है ना, विच मे बी बच्चे जो थोड़े लैक रह जाते हैं, मे बी यू ऑल्सो फेस पे कुछ बच्चे नहीं कर पाते हैं उस लेवल का, तो उसका रीज़न आई थिंक यही होता है कि बच्चों को हमने स्कूल में जो चीज़ करवाई है वो घर पे जाके रिपीट नहीं हुई, जहाँ पे हो जाती है दे आर ब्रिलियंट एंड दे आर शोइंग वंडरफुल रिजल्ट्स, बट जहाँ पे नहीं होती है वी फेल्स, तो वो पेरेंट्स को हमने कॉन्फिडेंस में लेके हाँ ये तो है, बट हाँ वो स्कूल, लेकिन अब उनको ये चीज़ बताना कि उनके टाइम पे कंपटीशन कहाँ था इतना. एंड नेक्स्ट वी हैव टू एनकरेज अ ग्रोथ माइंडसेट, है ना, एंड कम्युनिकेटिंग रेगुलरली विद टीचर्स, मतलब पेरेंट्स की ड्यूटी है ये कि वो टीचर्स से रेगुलरली कम्युनिकेट करें, और जो नहीं कर रहे हैं वहाँ पे हमें उनको कॉन्फिडेंस में लेना पड़ेगा. FLN आर क्रूशल फॉर एकेडमिक एंड पर्सनल डेवलपमेंट, इफेक्टिव टीचिंग स्ट्रेटजीज एंड असेसमेंट टेक्निक्स कैन हेल्प टू अचीव दीज गोल्स, एड्रेसिंग चैलेंजेस थ्रू कोलैबोरेशन एंड इनोवेटिव सॉल्यूशंस इज एसेंशियल. सो एज एजुकेटर्स एंड पेरेंट्स लेट्स कमिट टू फॉस्टरिंग अ सपोर्टिव एंड एनरिचिंग एनवायरमेंट फॉर आर चिल्ड्रंस फाउंडेशनल लर्निंग. By working together, we can build a strong foundation for their future success. So, thank you, everyone. And after that, we have our Nipun Bharat pledge.
Let's join hands.
To ensure
a conductive learning environment.
Enabling all children.
To achieve
foundational skills. We pledge to make
the school our place.
Joyful.
And experiential learning.
Where children can use
their language freely.
Ask questions freely. Play freely.
And where every child
is respected. Let us make the school
as well as the home
a place for developing
lifelong skills
for reading with comprehension
writing with purpose
and understanding numeracy
in every child
that they can apply
in their everyday life
situations. Let us strive
to make education meaningful
meaningful and joyful
for each child
of our country
and make every child
Nipun. Thank you.